Let's have a look at this problem where we cancel separate variables in as much as we have functions just in y and just in x, just in y and just in x. So we can certainly separate them, and it's an initial value problem. This example problem is going to show us that we cannot always express y explicitly in terms of x as far as our solution set is concerned. Our family of solutions, or in this instance perhaps a specific solution. Let's just begin by separating all our variables. We can keep e to the power 2y minus y on this side divided by e to the power y with respect to y, and that is going to equal the sine of 2x, which by trigonometric identity is the 2 times the sine of x cosine of x, divided by being this cosine of x on this side, so certainly those would cancel dx. Now this would be a difficult integral to do, but I can rewrite this by dividing this denominator into each of the components here of the numerator. That's going to leave me with an e to the power y minus y e to the power negative y dy, and that equals 2 times the sine of x dx. I can transform the equation by taking the integral of both sides. I'm just leaving the 2 on the outside because it's a constant coefficient. So here I'm going to be left with e to the power y dy minus the integral of y e to the power negative y dy, and that's going to equal negative 2 times the cosine of x plus some new constant, let's call it c1. Now this we'll have to do integration by parts. Let's just do that. We'll let u equals y, that means v prime has got to equal e to the power negative y. That leaves u prime to be 1 and v to be negative e to the power negative y. We're just using two parts. I've decided to let u equals y because if I take the first derivative of u, I get rid of, I just have a coefficient of 1, which means I am simplifying what comes after, and that is why I didn't choose this to be the u value. So here I'm going to be left with e to the power of y minus, let us see, it is uv, which is going to be negative y e to the power negative y minus the integral now of u prime v. So that becomes a positive e to the power negative y dy equals negative 2 times the cosine of x plus c1. And I just have to carry on, e to the power y minus negative y e to the power negative y, and this is going to be negative e to the power negative y equals negative 2 times the cosine of x plus c1 still. So the e of y, that's going to be a plus y e to the power negative y, going to be a plus e to the power negative y equals negative twice the cosine of x plus c1. And I suppose I can go a step or two further. I can say e to the power y plus, you'll be left with y plus 1 over e to the power y equals negative 2 times the cosine of x plus c1. But it's an initial value problem. Well, I can see it'd be impossible for me to explicitly get y on its own here, but e to the power 0 plus 1 over e to the power 0 equals negative 2 cosine of 0 is 1 plus c1. So that's going to be 1 plus 1 equals negative 2 plus c1. In other words, c1 equals 4. I've solved for c1. So my final answer is going to be e to the power y plus y plus 1 e to the power y equals 4 minus twice the cosine of x. So that's implicit, an implicit form. And I suppose one way to solve this is to bring this all to the one side, so that equals 0. and I'm going to construct, as we did in multivariable calculus, a new function in g in x and y, which is now going to equal this minus that. And I can look at one of the values for g, let it equal 0, which means I'm looking at one of the contours, of this z equals g of x and y function in three dimension, but I let z equal 0, for instance, so that's where the three dimensional surface is going to interact with the xy plane, where it intersects with the xy plane, which will give me this, which will give me a curve. But it's difficult just to have a look at this and to see what the curve is going to look like.